If you're currently a UK medical student or an international medical graduate wishing to practice in the UK, chances are you've heard of the new Medical Licensing Assessment, or MLA, which comes into full effect in 2025. But you might be wondering, why is the system changing? Or what exactly is the MLA? If so, we hope this short video can help as we explore the MLA from a medical student's perspective and its role in shaping today's students into tomorrow's doctors. The MLA consists of two key components: the Medical School Applied Knowledge Test, which is an online single best answer exam, and the Clinical and Professional Skills Assessment, which has the format of the familiar OSCE or OSLRs. The exams will be based on the MLA content map, and UK medical schools will deliver them locally. Meanwhile, for international graduates wishing to join the UK medical register, the PLAB system will be updated to align with MLA standards. The MLA will be a major milestone for medical education, with both national and international impact. The system aims to provide students with clearer clinical direction during their studies and boost their confidence as they transition into professional practice. Ultimately, it reinforces a consistent, holistic definition of what it means to graduate as a well-rounded doctor. This will assure organisations, colleagues and patients the medical graduates have the knowledge, skills and behaviours for good medical practice.
Meet Julia, a first-year medical student currently studying her GI block, which is one of the areas of clinical practice outlined in the MLA content map. By using this map, she's able to connect her lecture material not only to her end-of-year exams, but also to her future clinical practice, contextualising her learning for real-world application. The MLA content map guides students beyond memorising isolated facts. It ensures they develop a solid foundation in different topics, from biomedical sciences to medical ethics and law, enabling them to navigate complex medical conditions and make responsible, evidence-based decisions. The MLA content map also provides a structured yet flexible framework for medical schools, allowing for variety in teaching methods, whilst ensuring consistent standards for medical competencies. This unique balance between promoting innovation and standardisation in medical education means that patients can be assured that every doctor joining the UK Medical Register is equipped with the knowledge and professionalism to deliver safe, effective care.
Now in her second year, Julia is honing her consultation and examination skills for her upcoming OSCE. She revises a gastrointestinal station, recalling key knowledge from her lectures, including patient presentations like jaundice and conditions such as pancreatic cancer. As she practices, she considers how she would explain the biochemical effects of alcohol abuse to a patient, while also integrating the psychological principles important for the consultation. In an OSCE, Julia is assessed not only on her medical knowledge, but also on her ability to apply it in real-world scenarios, addressing both the clinical and personal needs of the patient. Through this, she's developing her clinical and professional capabilities. The CPSA focuses on these skills, evaluating essential competencies like forming management plans, assessing risk, and safeguarding vulnerable patients.
Now in her fourth year, Julia is on placement, regularly encountering new patient presentations, from chronic rashes to breast lumps. She's learning how to recognise these signs and investigate them effectively. At the same time, she's honing practical skills, like taking bloods, with growing confidence. The MLA content map and its supplementary document on practical skills and procedures emphasise that medical students must not only perform procedures safely, but also understand the rationale behind clinical investigations and interpret results in the context of each individual patient.
After 5 years of hard work, Julia, now a final year medical student, faces her last challenge, the MLA. Although nervous, she draws confidence from her extensive preparation, rooted from her journey through medical school, through lectures, OSCEs, and clinical placements. As she begins the exam, she harnesses the comprehensive framework provided by her medical education to address the questions with self-assurance. Upon passing the UK MLA, Julia advances to her foundation years with confidence in her knowledge, skills and professional conduct, knowing these standards are reflected in her colleagues too. She graduates as a safe, competent and empathetic doctor.
As the organisation setting standards for UK doctors, the GMC must ensure that medical education translates into excellence in patient care. In a constantly evolving world, healthcare standards must remain high, whilst adapting to the changing needs of the population. The MLA prioritises patient care, aligning educational objectives between students and universities, and providing a clear path from classroom learning to clinical practice. Most importantly, it prepares doctors who are ready for safe practice, can manage uncertainty, and are committed to delivering patient-centred care. This will empower tomorrow's doctors and patients alike for a future of good medical practice. Thank you for watching our video.